Makar Shankranti, which is the harvest festival, is celebrated in Tamil Nadu as Pongal. For the people of Tamil Nadu, Pongal reminds them of two common delicious dishes. It's predominantly made with the newly harvested rice on the Pongal day. Today, I'm going to be sharing some amazing facts about rice. So welcome back to this short Pongal special episode on Munch and Mull. Keep watching. In the Indian tradition, a child is introduced to rice through a ritual called annaprashanam. Rice is also used in rituals of marriage, grihapravesham, and at the end of one's life, a person is bid adieu on his death through rice grains. This is not without a reason. Did you know that India and Southeast Asia have been home to an incredible variety of rices? And now I'm going to be sharing with you some amazing facts on the diversity of rice. How many varieties of rice do most of us eat? Perhaps 3 to 5 at best. Am I right? And of course, all of it is fully polished and white, so we hardly know the difference of one from another. But how many varieties of rice do you think were grown in India, say, a century or two ago? 100, 1000 or 10,000? Sounds like a lot? Well, scientists estimate that over 1 lakh varieties of rice were once grown across India. The decline of this incredible genetic diversity began during the British colonization and peaked after the Green Revolution in 1960. At this time, Dr. R.H. Richaria, then director of the Central Rice Research Institute, Orissa, undertook a journey from India's west coast to its east coast to collect varieties of rice being grown across India. He himself collected about 22,500 varieties of rice. This was the biggest Indian collection and the second biggest in the world. But how many varieties of rice do you think are grown in India today? You won't believe it. Even today, that number is estimated to be around 6,000 plus varieties. But that is a steep drop from even Dr. Richaria's time, just in 5 decades. This loss is largely attributed to the Green Revolution. There are various NGO initiatives that have tried to conserve what little is left. A good example is Save Our Rice campaign initiated by a Kerala-based NGO called Tunnel. This initiative has conserved over 1,100 varieties of rice. There are many more initiatives like this at work across India. I want you to contrast it with the number of varieties of rice that you eat. There's a lot more to say, which we will reserve for another episode. Even what I have said today is worth mulling over, isn't it? Are you wondering what's the point in conserving these rice varieties? Any climate change specialist will tell you that conserving these genetic diversity of rice is an insurance to the agriculture of the future. But unless you and I are ready to use these rice varieties, why should the farmer grow it? Research indicates that different rice varieties have different micronutrient profiles, which significantly have a positive impact on our health. Is this not a strong incentive to include a wide variety of rices in our diet? For more than 5 years now, it's been our good fortune to be using more than 20 varieties of organically grown, unpolished and semi-polished rice varieties. This is thanks to BioBasics, of which my husband is a part. If you would want to know more about BioBasics rices, do check the link given below in the description. All of us like variety in our wardrobes. So does this episode inspire you to include more varieties of traditional rice in your diet? And if you like this episode, do leave your comments in the comment section below. Here's wishing you a very happy and joyous Pongal.